Happy Sunday, everybody. It is a beautiful weekend here in Aspen, Colorado. The leaves have trees on them now, and things are starting to feel just a little bit more normal in all of this chaos. You guys have been hearing all week about masks and construction and reopening and Board of Health meetings. So I know that you're on the up and up on the update. So what I wanted to do this week was actually talk about a few things that maybe aren't in the news, just very briefly, so you can kind of feel like you got a little bit of backroom access going on. So the first thing I wanted to point out is of our $6.5 million relief dollars, $350,000 of those dollars have been earmarked and have gone out to the most vulnerable amongst us, our undocumented working population. Now, these funds are for those who were here working undocumented, but otherwise employed and doing well, and have fallen on particularly hard times because of the COVID-19 crisis, not because of previous status or any of that other stuff. And it's really important for us as a community to say, no humans are illegal and we got your back. And when federal dollars cannot land for you, your community is gonna stand up and support you. So I am really proud of that. I thank ACF, and all of those $350,000 are going to all three counties. So Pitkin, Garfield, and Eagle, our entire valley, our entire watershed, and are for food, shelter, medical expenses, and utilities only. So that's a nice thing. As it relates to working with others, there is, in addition to a COVID crisis, a huge reduction in the price of coal and natural gas. And what that has meant in our watershed is that a lot of workers out in Garfield County who work in those extractive industries have been laid off. Average income there is $28,000. A server here makes more than that. And so we're beginning conversations to reach out to those communities and saying, hey, would you like to be retrained? Would you like to come work in Aspen or in the Upper Valley? And it is an opportunity to come together with people who perhaps are more conservative or have different views and say, hey, we've got this ladder and we value you and your work. And coming together across partisan lines right now in a way that helps our environment is such a silver lining. So this is also something that I just think is really cool and that you guys may wanted to have known about. Thirdly, some locals put on a We Are the New World Summit on Friday, and that brought together top leaders from politics and Hollywood, movies, writers, wellness, yoga, capitalism, CEOs of major companies to talk about how can we emerge on the other side better than we went into this crisis. And the thing that I heard the most was this idea of empathetic listening and expanding the horizon of our empathy. So actively going out and speaking to people who you know you have disagreements with, not to make a point, not to argue, but to ask questions and listen and try to understand how those people arrived where they did and at those positions. It's certainly been my experience that when we can open up in that spirit of inquiry rather than judgment, you often find that even the things that you find to be most abhorrent, when you understand the life story, you could see yourself inhabiting that same position if those were your life experiences and vice versa. And what that allows us to do is work together towards solutions. So that's what I took from that, and I put that challenge back out on you if you weren't able to get there. Once a week, find someone who, different politically, different racially, ethnically, or just dispositionally, and ask questions about why, and be willing to hear and incorporate their thoughts. The last thing I want to leave you with is a conversation. As we open more on May 9th and hopefully thereafter, we are going to have to balance the trade-off between allowing some of us to move and open up our economy and our ability to understand what's actually happening. And that is primarily around contact tracing, right? So what does that mean? It means like we have for decades, individuals, for sure, finding out who has the virus and who they've interacted with where, so that those individuals can be isolated and provided services for, right? And that part is non-controversial. There is no question that we are doing that, we can do that, we are standing up an army of contact tracers right now, and that's great. And we need that as a first step, because once we know where those people are, there has to be a physical human around to do that real work of delivering services and isolating. But the question is, can 20, 25 people provide enough data to know where an individual is when they get the virus? Or do we need a tech-based platform, as many other places have done, South Korea is a great example, that allow us to proactively know when someone has symptoms or gets sick, and to know exactly where they have been during that period, so that our tracers, our people, can be most effective? And there are legitimate concerns around privacy that need to be weighed. But ultimately, this is a community decision. And you know, we have a choice, right? We can use this in-person network and hope that it's enough. But if it's not, and it may be, but if it's not, then you know, we have to ask the real question. Does it make logical sense for 100% of us to not go about our regular lives for the 5% who are not doing well? Or does it make sense to find, using all the tools at our disposal, those 5% early enough to care for them and deliver services and isolate them so the other 95% can go about their normal lives during this crisis? So that's the question that I put out to you guys. I'd love to get your feedback and thoughts. The next couple weeks are when we're gonna have to make these decisions prior to June. And I don't know this for a fact, but I would posit that this choice around the degree of contact tracing on the spectrum of Sweden, which says, hey, older people stay at home, everyone else get out there, get sick and build herd immunity, we're cool, to South Korea that says everybody every day is required to have an app and to log your health anonymously. Tell us how you're feeling. And if you're not feeling well, we'll make sure to show up with what you need, but we're also gonna make sure that you don't go spread that for multiple days to everybody else in the interim. And that's sort of the spectrum we're working on. So that's it, guys. I hope you have a beautiful summer. Get outside and enjoy it. Please wear your masks and social distance. This can come back rapidly. Don't be that person, and enjoy this beautiful summer-like weather.